My fellow prophecy student, greetings. It is God's desire for us to have a working knowledge of the prophecies through a meaningful Bible study of the books of Daniel and Revelation. Contrary to what some believe, Revelation is not a sealed book. As the name suggests, it is intended to reveal information about future events in a systematic and cohesive manner. At the end of this video, I'm going to tell you where you can download a free book entitled 7 Steps to Becoming an End Time Prophecy Expert in 48 Hours. It will give you more information as to how you can revolutionize your understanding of Bible prophecy from basic to advanced. Here are some tips that you can use to guide you to a better understanding of end time Bible predictions. They have helped me tremendously, and I believe they can do the same for you. Tip number 1. Pray and ask God for guidance. In recognition of the need for divine enlightenment, the psalmist entreated the Lord, saying, "Open thou mine eyes, that I may behold wondrous things out of thy law." At the start of each Bible study, breathe a word of prayer to the Lord for guidance. The light from the Bible in general, and the prophetic word in particular, does not come by one's theological acumen or academic stature. It is the direct result of divine intervention. A failure to recognize this will result in spiritual ignorance and a lack of spiritual growth. Tip number 2. Allow the Bible alone to interpret all prophecy symbols. Many prophecy students have gotten into the bad habit of giving meanings to things they have no instruction to interpret. When it comes to giving interpretation to symbols, that's the sole prerogative of the Bible. Therefore, we must allow the scriptures to provide all solutions. Remember, interpretation belongs only to God, and no prophecy is of private interpretation. Genesis chapter 40 and verse 8, 2 Peter 1 and verse 20 respectively. Tip number 3. Accept the biblical interpretations of prophecy symbols exactly as stated in the scriptures. Do not try to paraphrase or reinterpret any of the biblical solutions. If they are intended for our enlightenment, they must be implicitly accepted. As evident in many articles and in videos on YouTube, the restatement of interpretations given in the scriptures is a common practice, especially among theologians. Many such theologians would read the stated interpretation of a symbol in the scripture and rephrase it, thinking to make it clearer. However, this is not a particularly good habit to adopt, as it will only mystify that which is made plain. Tip number 4. Do not speculate about the meaning of things that the Bible does not interpret. If there is a particular thing for which you do not see a biblical interpretation, treat it for its obvious meaning or as a prop in the vision. A good example of this principle is found in Joseph's interpretation of Pharaoh's first dream in Genesis 41. In the dream, Pharaoh saw a river, meadow, and cows, but only cows were interpreted, and everything else was treated as a prop in the vision. Yet the meaning of the dream was perfectly understood. Tip number 5. Your conclusion on a prophecy must be in harmony with every prophecy that is parallel to it. Parallel prophecies are prophecies that cover the same event or set of events over the same period. For example, Daniel chapter 2 and 7 are parallel prophecies. Make sure your conclusion on these prophecies harmonize. Two prophecies that are saying the same thing in different ways cannot contradict each other. It is quite evident in the book of Revelation that in order to explain some of the prophecies, you need to compare it with parallel prophecies in other books of the Bible, like Daniel. The beauty about the parallel prophecies is that you can use them to explain one event from different angles. Tip number 6. Read Bible commentaries on Bible prophecy from different authors on the specific subject matter you are researching. You need not be in perfect agreement with the views of the Bible commentators. You can still get some value even from those with whom you have differences of opinion. When you draw from the works of others, it expands your mind and exposes you to other ideas that can help you deal with challenges from difficult Bible passages. Tip number 7. In your prophecy studies and discussions, do not pretend to be a Mr. Know-it-all. The most critical factor in your endeavors to understand the book of Revelation is the mindset with which you approach Bible studies. If you believe that you already know everything, you will learn nothing. But if you enter upon your study with an earnest desire to better understand the word, even if you are a fairly advanced student, your mind would be naturally receptive to new truths. The extent to which one considers himself doctrinally self-sufficient is usually an indication of a lack of appreciation for a new way of thinking. Tip number 8. Do not study Bible prophecy in order to fall in line with the orthodox or mainstream views. Not everything in Bible prophecy that is popular with the prophecy experts is necessarily true. Whatever conclusion you arrive at in your prophecy studies, make sure it is something you can explain independent of what is fed to you from your Sabbath or Sunday school teacher, your pastor, or in a seminar. I am not suggesting that you must not listen to your Bible instructor or even your favorite prophecy commentator on TV. I am simply advising you to be like the Bereans, who receive the word with all readiness of mind and search the scriptures daily whether those things were so. And that is found in the book of Acts chapter 17 and verse 11. In other words, seek to acquire the ability to explain the prophecies for yourself. Tip number 9. Attend prophecy seminars and do prophecy courses. Many advanced prophecy students will tell you that one of the things that helped them to improve their prophecy studies is the attendance of prophecy seminars. They will also tell you that this is how they get to know how to explain certain difficult passages in Bible prophecy. You too can be benefited in this way. Again, you don't need to agree in every particular with the Bible instructor, but there is always something to learn at these seminars. You may find a prophecy seminar more helpful than others. By regular attendance, you should be able to know which one better contributes to your understanding of the prophetic word. And remember, make sure you do your own private studies and research to check the validity of what you are taught in prophecy class. And finally, tip number 10. Be honest with yourself in arriving at your conclusions. One of the most important factors in prophecy study is intellectual honesty. Very often, we study the Bible just to arrive at the same understanding as our church. Unfortunately, many prophecy students seem to be governed by the notion that the church they attend is God's organization, therefore, everything they teach is the truth. People who pursue this practice very often end up denying the truth, however plain it is in the Bible. That's one of the disadvantages of denominational association. It gets you so immersed in partisan church politics that you deny the word of God. When you are studying Bible prophecy, don't be afraid to go where the evidence leads you, even if it puts you at variance with what is regarded as the orthodox position. That is not to say that none of the orthodox teachings on Bible prophecy is true. Just do not make orthodox a necessary standard to emulate. Neither should you consider it a federal offense to depart from the mainstream. As truth is progressive, so should your study of the prophetic word progress. As you elevate from basic to advanced in your understanding of the end time prophecies of Daniel and Revelation, thank the Lord continually for his revelations and continue to express your desire for more of his truths. Some of the times you may be wrong in your theological prognosis, but you must remember that it is God who is responsible for your enlightenment, hence the need to depend on him continually for the imparting of truth. May the blessing promised to those who read and understand the prophecies of the Bible be yours as you diligently study its sacred pages. If you wish to be better prepared for the time of the end through a better understanding of the predictions of Daniel and John, if you wish to overhaul your understanding of end time prophecies, you can get started with one of the most revolutionary prophecy studies you have ever seen. Click the link below and get a free download of the ebook entitled 7 Steps to Becoming an End Time Prophecy Expert in 48 Hours. I sincerely hope you have enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.